Thank you for tuning in to watch this video. I wanted to give you a little better understanding of what I am doing with this video and what is in it and why. So I've taken a lot of photography and a lot of video, but out of respect for some of the things that I've taken those photos and videos of, I am not including in here certain burial grounds, certain things that would be disrespectful. I also want to make it noted that in no way, shape, or form is there anything that I am obtaining from this video other than speaking of the Hopi people, their prophecy, and hoping that you will gain a better understanding and respect for who they are and what is to come and what they know. So with that said, the narrative that I've created within this, I've given some very specific stories about the things that I've seen. And it will be up to you to glean from it what it is behind it. Because as these things go, what I've learned from the Hopi is that they do not share the information with you. If you ask them a question and you don't know the answer, they aren't going to offer it. It's almost as if you know the answer and you speak it, they'll confirm it, but they won't give you the answer. Which I fully appreciate and understand, because this is how I've received much of the information that I've received about the things that I've been shown, and also how I convey it to you. As I say, I lift up the rock and say, look, and it's up to you to see it. The Hopi are very much the same way. I would like to make a note at what a humble people they are, and that across all of their reservation land, they have refused all of the connections with government, with the exception of the agreements, but they have not taken it upon themselves to become casinos and to be wealthy. So the land is very humble, and in many eyes they would see it as impoverished, but the Hopi see it very different, that the value that they possess is far greater than any of the worldly values, which is something that I absolutely adore about these people. That within their faces, within their eyes, within their spirits, you can feel who they are. They don't have to tell you. You can feel who they are. The things that you're seeing and that is reflected within their artwork, these are things that these people have seen before and are spoken of within their oral traditions. They do not write these things down. They do not commercialize their work. They live off of the land that they have, and they are incredibly wonderful people and very inviting. There are many people that camp out right there on the reservation and have been, and they're not removed because their prophecies call for it. So I encourage you to just keep an open mind and an open heart and understand that this isn't a National Geographic expose of a people. This is about helping you understand where they come from, who they are, so that you might find the truths behind the things that they do. Seek, and ye shall find. I love you very much, and I hope you enjoy this. On August 7, 1970, a spectacular UFO sighting was witnessed by dozens of people and photographed by Chuck Roberts of the Prescott, Arizona Courier. This sighting occurred after a UFO calling by Paul Solomon and several Hopi Indians. This sighting was interpreted by some Hopis as being a partial fulfillment of a certain Hopi prophecy given by the Great Spirit Masao and inscribed on Second Mesa, warning of the coming Purification Day, when the true Hopi will be flown to other planets in ships without wings. Many of my people, understanding the prophecy, shall be safe. Those who stay and live in the places of my people also shall be safe. Then there will be much to rebuild. The war will be a spiritual conflict with material matters. Material matters will be destroyed by spiritual beings who will remain to create one world and one nation under one power, that of the Creator. That time is not far off. Time is indeed short. The Hopi people represent four corners and four pillars. They're unique in so many ways and so humble. It truly makes me think of the meek shall inherit the earth. I believe these to be some of the meek. The landscape as we drove changed so dramatically at times, it was like driving across a different planet. And some of the monuments are so staggering that they would be like skyscrapers. Pictures cannot do this justice. The other monuments are clearly ancient, ancient buildings, structures for kings and gods. And you have to ask yourself, who made these? You can see the remnants as though they've fallen, the dirt, and what the Hopi see at night is staggering. None of these things pass their eyes without recognition or admiration. They don't climb to the rooftops or to the mountaintops and scream that they are Hopi. They are truly a humble people, and the vastness of the land is overwhelming. They have kept this land very humble. I started at the four corners. Now this four corners structure is unique. This is managed by Bureau of Land Management, and this is the four corners of the state. I'm sure you recognize the shape of that as you've seen it in crop circles before. The building to the right is directional. There is something about it, as you see in this Google Earth, as I'll also show on top of this, that it is unique. All ancient structures seem to have a directional beacon, and that's what these seem to be. The four corners is placed in the middle of nowhere. Why on earth would a government build such a monument? What, just to celebrate the four corners of four states? I don't think so. There's much more here that I can't really explain, but if you examine the structure and the architecture of this, it's very specific. BLM agents approached while I was there shooting with the drone. I complimented them on the color of their clothing and that choice, because it's black. And you know, I love black. We took a dirt road from there because Four Corners is about an hour and a half away from the Hopi Reservation. It cut some time for us. It was a bit of a bumpy road for a minivan. The music you're hearing is Hopi. When we arrived at the cultural center, I found that it was humble at every turn, and the eyes of the people in the artwork and around the facility reflected that of a people that knew something that they don't tell anybody. Their statues, their monuments, and their carvings show people that most tribes never speak of. The clouds were amazing that day. The landscape, the volcanoes, and the dinosaur footprints are everywhere around these lands. The footprints you see are of a small dinosaur. There are much bigger. The artwork of the Hopi is very specific, much like the Egyptians. It represents cryptography. Imagery holds secrets.
and they tell these secrets in their art. I find the eyes of the Hopi to be amazing. They are a peaceful people. The reflection of their attire and their hair certainly brings up images that you've seen before. The artwork of the Hopi and the people within the artwork, many have white skin, many have red skin, which reflects the prophecy. The white skin are people, according to their prophecies, not from here. Considering the age of these prophecies, they had to tuck these things away. So they have a time capsule. And this time capsule is to be opened at the appointed time. And I believe what's in there is the broken tablet and the missing piece of the broken tablet that Pahana, the white man from space, is told to bring. Who has that broken piece of the tablet? The artwork also reflects a remarkable thing. You will see butterflies adorning each side of this piece of art. And up at the top, pay very close attention to the imagery. The butterfly is significant in all Hopi artwork, representing transmutation. You'll recognize the butterflies here are actually butterfly people. The Hopi's artwork is truly stunning at every level. It's modern and ancient all at the same time. When I saw this piece of art, chills went down my spine. A butterfly on the hand of a white man, Pahana. This butterfly representing transmutation. And no, this isn't MK Ultra. This has been around for many thousands of years before MK Ultra. What does MK Ultra know in the CIA? Well, I have a better question. What does the Hopi know that the CIA and nobody else knows? They are very quiet and very reserved people, so don't expect the answers to come from them. They rely on you to find them yourself.